So now we will discuss how to create columns in MS Word document. So first of all, open MS Word and then we will apply the options that we have discussed earlier. Okay. So first, open MS Word. Then we can divide our page into different columns. So you may have seen in newspapers, magazines and some other documents that contain text in the form of columns. So generally columns are included in a document to improve its readability. So first, what we have to do to create columns, just go to in page layout view. Here you can see. Go to page layout view, and after that you can see there are different options, and this one option is column option. Just click on this column option, then these are the options, columns 1, 2, 3, left, right. So how many columns you need, you can choose from here. For example, we need 3 columns. So we can click here on 3. Now this page is divided into 3 columns. Okay, how to check it? So you can check it just by typing something. So I am trying to type randomly some paragraphs. So let's see whether the columns has been created or not. Suppose we need 5 paragraphs. Okay. Each paragraph is having 5 lines or 6 lines, for example. Then write this formula and then press enter. Now you can see 3 columns are there, 1, 2, and 3. 3 columns we have created, 3 columns here on the document. So this is the way you can create divided columns. But in case you need more than 3 columns, then what to do? We can divide our page into more than 3 columns. Then there is an option that is called as more columns. You can go to more columns and then finally just click on columns. Here you can go to more columns. If you need more than 3 columns, then click on more columns. Then this dialog box is appeared. We have this dialog box, and in this dialog box all the options, previous options, are also there. 1, 2, 3, left and right. Okay, now there is an option here, number of columns. You can see, you can, the default value is here 3, because we have created 3 columns right now. Just click on this, you can change the value 4. Now the columns will be 4, 5, etc. And the number of columns, how many number of columns you need, you can click, you can increase or decrease. So for example, we need now 4 columns. Okay, now click on OK. So you can see the page has been divided into 4 columns. So now you can remember, this is the method which is used in newspapers to write news. Okay, now we will discuss the next topic, that is inserting images, how to insert images. So for example, when you create a text document using Word, you may need to include some images. So images are added to textual document for a wide variety of reasons. Why? From supporting the description provided in the text to providing an immediate visual impact of the content. Okay, so to create a visual effect of the content, we insert image. Okay, now how to insert image? Just go to insert option here. Now create another page here also. This is the next page. Okay, you can see, and we can create here. Now go to normal option, one column, and then we are going to insert image. First go to insert option to insert image, and then click on this option that is called picture. Okay, so where you have to insert picture, click here, click on this option, then you can see this dialog box. Now you can search images in your document. For example, I am going to insert pictures which are already available in my system, that is in sample pictures. Okay. In sample pictures, different kinds of images are also there. Click on any image, and then after that click on insert option, this option. Okay. So now you can see image has appeared on the page, this image. In this way you can insert image. Okay, now we will learn how to insert shapes, how to insert shapes in our document. So to insert shapes, as I discussed in previous video, go to insert option once again, then check the options. This one is the picture, this is outline pictures, and after that this is the option of shapes. Okay, you can see different shapes are available here. Click on this option. Now different shapes are here, you can see any text box, line, arrow line, here rectangle, ellipse, or rounded round corner, rectangle, triangle, etc., etc., star, and rectangles. Different kinds of rectangles are here. Basic shapes, you can see black block arrows, equation shapes, okay, flow chart shapes, stars and banners, and callouts, and different shapes are available here. So which image do you need? You can click on the image. Suppose for example we need a triangle, then click on triangle. Now how to insert image, how to insert shape in our document? So drag the mouse, click left click and drag the mouse, then you can see image is also being formatted, shape is also being formatted, and it also appeared, has also appeared on the document. Okay, so now release the mouse button, then you can see the selected shape. Okay, now the different handles are also available in this shape option. You can perform various options. For example, the color of the image, color of the shape is now blue. Here you can change this color, shape fill here with the help of this option, shape fill. You can change this color, or if you don't need any color, then click here. Okay, now you can change the outline of the image. For example, you need any color image, any color outline, then click on the specific color. Okay, now shape effect, different kinds of effects are also here. You can choose any of the option. For example, we need shadow in our image. Now this is the method how you can insert shapes and you can insert image in our document. Okay, so these are the different shapes and the method how to insert. Now we come to the point, the how to format an image or shape. How to format? First, what is the meaning of formatting? First go to the previous image, this image here. Now we have to format this image. Formatting means we have to change. We can do basically two things. First, we can resize the image or shape, and we can rotate an image or shape. Okay, so what to do? First click on the image that you want to, we'll discuss about the image first, then click on the image, then you can see different handles are available here. Okay, these are the handle, corner handles. So with the help of these corner handles you can resize. Click on any corner handle, here, and by left click drag the mouse. Okay, here. So now you can see, now release the mouse, left click, and then you can see the image is resized, means the size of image is decreased now. Okay, you can also increase the size by just dragging it outside, but by just clicking left click, select left click, and then drag it outside. Okay, you can increase the width, increase the size. Okay, now how to rotate this image? You can also rotate, then select the image, and you can see this symbol here. This is a handle to rotate. Click on this symbol, left click, and then wherever you want to move it, you can rotate it. Okay, if you go to upward direction, then the image will be moved into left anticlockwise, and in downward direction the image will be into the clockwise direction, move into clockwise direction. Okay, so where you want to do, you want to move it either in the left side or right side, you can perform it very easily. Okay, in the same way you can also format the shape. Just go to the shape option, where is the shape we have inserted, this is the shape. Now you can increase, as I told you earlier, you can increase and decrease the size of the image, size of the shape, by just dragging it outside. You can increase the height by just clicking on this bottom handle. So you can do whatever you like, and if you want to rotate this, then you can rotate it also. Okay, by just using the same handle as in the image. Okay, so this is the method you can format an image, and you can format a shape. Now we'll discuss the last topic of this chapter, that is inserting symbols. So what are symbols? Symbols, for example, the dollar, okay, at the rate, okay, rupee symbol, these are the symbols. So some of the symbols are available over the keyboard. This, for example, hash, dollar, percent, and star, these symbols are available on the keyboard, but some of the symbols are not there. For example, if you need angle symbol, can you insert from the keyboard? No, there is no angle symbol on the keyboard. So basically we need symbols, some symbols in mathematics. If you need any symbol, for example, alpha symbol, beta symbol, omega symbol in science, and you need micron symbol, or at you need less than, equal to, greater than, plus minus, both equal to, so these symbols are not available on the keyboard. Then what to do, how to insert these kinds of symbols in our document? So to insert these kinds of symbols in our document, just go to insert option. Once again, go to insert option, then just come to the right side, topmost right corner here, click on the symbol option. Okay, click on this arrow here, black triangle, then different symbols are here. Frequently used symbols are here. For example, multiply symbol, this is the increment symbol. Here you can tilde symbol, you can see let in capital letter I. Okay, plus minus, and not equal to, okay, alpha, beta, etc., etc. So you can insert whatever you like. Just click over here, beta. Suppose we have to insert beta, then click beta. If we need alpha, then click here alpha. If we need, means click on the symbol that you need, this copyright symbol. But for example, we need some more symbols, we don't need these symbols, we need, for example, any another symbol, then click on more symbols. Okay, now you can see the more options and you can choose any another symbol. For example, the omega symbol was not there. Here you can see. So you can click here on this symbol and click on insert here in the right side corner. Click on insert. Okay. Then you can see the symbol has appeared, omega, alpha, beta, and at the rate, this is the copyright symbol and ohm symbol used in science for the resistance. You can see. So in this way, you can format image, you can insert image, you can insert shape, you can format shape, and you can insert different symbols, and you can also divide your page into different columns. Okay, so this is the end of your chapter. In the next video, we will discuss chapter number 7, that is working with tables.